with you. How is it that we're taking folk that don't like us and rejected us to our new place? Why is it that you're shouting for a new place? Y'all ready for this? But you keep trying to take everybody that stopped you from getting forward in the first place with you. Can I tell you, if you take them jokers with you, your new place gonna look like your old place? You better look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, but God wants to do a new thing in you. He wants to make some things turn around in you. Well, here it is, because these rejected folk that I'm talking to will understand this. People get scared. Watch this. You can't testify to this unless you've been rejected. People get scared when the one they rejected start coming up. There's a change of attitude, because on one hand, brother, they want to be happy. But on the other hand, they're mad because now they can't run your life no more. Look at your neighbor and say, but it stops today. It stops today. I know folk been trying to keep me down. I know folk been talking about me. Folk been trying to get me to do what they want me to do, but it stops today. Please just prophesy to your neighbor and say, neighbor, I can't stay here like this. I can't stay here. I can't keep crying about the same thing. Am I talking to somebody in here? Just nudge your neighbor and let's make them mad now, because I'm getting ready to have some real church in here. Come on, nudge your neighbor. Elbow your neighbor and just say, neighbor, we got to change our position. We got to change our place in life. We cannot stay here like this. Times are getting hard, and the only thing that's going to sustain us is our new position, which means some of us in here don't even know what it is to get on our knees and seek God's face. Why? Because the church stopped teaching the real elements of foundation of Jesus Christ. Okay, y'all missing it. Maybe y'all didn't, but I've been in some churches where the young people, you say speak in tongues or talk about tongues or talk about the Holy Ghost, they don't know nothing, but turn the lights on and they can twerk with it, they can rock with it, they can roll with it in church. Okay, y'all not gonna talk to me. They let me whip and do the name. Y'all gonna talk in here, or y'all acting like y'all just that same, like you ain't slipped up and said something about somebody or talked wrong about somebody or lied on somebody? Are you sitting there like God didn't save you for something? Are you sitting there acting like you ain't got no sin when he said, for all have sinned and come short? Are you sitting there like you didn't need new grace and mercy this morning to get? Are you sitting there like your body is not working and pain? You better look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I got to get the foundation of my life back. I'll be with you in a minute, son. I'll be there in a minute. Five rejected folk. You gotta ask yourself some questions. The first question you have to ask yourself, and I'm almost out of here, y'all. Thank y'all for being patient, but I wish I had about five people that's ready to have some real good praise, church. And I really want the men to praise with me. The women gonna sit there and look at me bougie, like I don't know what I'm talking about. But if you got your Bibles open, be a 2 Kings. I'll be there in 1 minute. Hey, the first question you have to ask yourself is, Do I stay like this and keep complaining about what I have the power to change but won't? Ryan, the thing you gotta ask yourself, bro, is, do I stay like this and I have the power to change everything in my life, but I don't want to, because where I'm at in life is so comfortable. Are y'all with me this afternoon? It is so comfortable for me to be right here. It's comfortable for me to be in a bad relationship. It's comfortable for me just to sit at home and don't do nothing. It's comfortable for me to try to fit in a crowd that really don't like me, that every time something go down, they try to plot against me. It's comfortable for me to remain right here. It's comfortable for me to come to church week after week and nobody gets saved. It's comfortable for me to come to church week after week and I don't feel a real move of God, where it doesn't matter about time. It doesn't matter. Maybe it doesn't happen here, but I've been some places, y'all, where you come in and it's like pulling nails to get people to praise God. But the very people that won't praise God is the very people that come and ask the pastor and the preacher, can you pray for me? No, Negro, pray for yourself. Oh, my bad. I'm sorry. That's the only one you're going to get. You better be acting like God has allowed Jesus to die for a reason. He died. When he died, the veil was ripped. You can go to him for yourself. But why ask me when he says, I showed up and you didn't say nothing? Y'all not going to talk to me. I came and you didn't do nothing. I had my bag with me to give you your blessing, but you acted like the miracle wasn't in the house. You better tell your neighbor, this is still the church. This is still the house of God, and his presence still remains. What are you going to do while you're here? So there is a text right here in 2 Kings chapter 7. Do me a favor, about five of y'all just shout preach, please. Shout preach. there's some statements here in 2 Kings chapter 7. There's a statement here in 2 Kings chapter 7. When you get to 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 3, look at verse 3. Verse 3 says, must we stay here and die? There's four men with leprosy. There is four men with leprosy. They have leprosy. They have been rejected from their hometown. There's four men with leprosy. Now, how did we ride to four men? Let's ride this text real quick. If you go back to chapter 6, don't go there. I'm going to tell you what it says. If you go back to chapter 6, you want to talk about transformation in perilous times. Let me tie it with this text right here. Yeah, what happens now is, in perilous times, in that situation, there's a famine that comes to the land because the prophet Elisha begins to blind the enemy, and he takes the enemy to the camp of Israel. Y'all watch this. Which Israel was plotted in Samaria at this point in time, and they were in there, and Elisha begins to take the enemies. He blinds them and takes them, and they follow him, and he leads them right into the middle, watch this y'all, of Israel's camp. And then Elisha now opens their eyes. Watch this text unfold. He then opens their eyes. After he opens their eyes, they get to see, watch this, everything that they want, which means they got to see all the people's houses. They got to see all the people's food. They got to see all the people's stuff. And the enemy now leaves. When the enemy leaves, Israel think they all together and everything is cool. But then there comes a time when the enemy has seen what he wants, and he comes back to get exactly what he wants. Am I talking to somebody in here, huh? Or y'all lost? Let me tell you right there, if you want to follow along, I'm in chapter 6, at the latter part of chapter 6. And now there becomes a famine in the land. While there's a famine in the land, what ends up happening is two women, this is where I'm going to preach from, two women, Elder Morgan, begin to say to themselves, why don't we eat your child today and we'll eat my child tomorrow? Am I talking to somebody in here? Can I stop to pause parenthetically to tell you, don't, watch this, allow folk, watch this, to take your stuff first. Because ain't it just like black folk to get you to give up all of your stuff, and then when it comes their time to share, they ain't got none? Okay, let me come down y'all row and preach thugs down in. That's what you want. Here it is. Ain't it funny how you can pay for dinner today, and then y'all go out to lunch tomorrow, and them chokers ain't never got no money, but they say they got their check, and they got a job, and they got paid. Wait a minute. I bought that.
You're right.
I really thought that you was gonna be fair. Okay, I'll come this side. Y'all look interesting, huh? I thought they was gonna be fair, and if I cook today, they'll cook tomorrow. But now all of a sudden they ain't got no food, but they just went grocery shopping. Bro, ain't it amazing? You can give me $50 today, or I give you $50 today, and I give you $50 a day, and I say, hey man, let me get that back next week, and you be like, cool, you know, I get paid next week, but I ain't heard from you, and we in next week. But you ain't good on my $50. Or am I in the house? You, everybody down your road can look at that. You mad at somebody right now? I wish they just give me my money back. I'm tired of seeing them get new Jordans and they ain't even paying their rent to stay with me. They rent out my room, won't even buy toilet paper. Y'all not talking to me. I know y'all messing with this mic. Please leave it like it is. Please. Here it is. So you find out now. Watch this. That these women have a problem because the woman now who has given her child. Watch this, y'all. Sees the king coming down the street. The king is coming down the street. Now, brother musician, what happens is this woman has found herself in perilous time. Because what happens to her is her mentality of giving her only child is now messing with her. Y'all should read the Bible. Y'all should have your Bible open and look at it. It's right there. It's messing with her. She says, King, I gave my child. We ate my child. And she didn't come through for dinner for the day. The king gets mad. King storms back. And he says, I want Elisha's head.